All praises, all praises, all praises to the heavenly creator of infinity, eternity, the universe, the stars, the earth, the waters, the mountains, the clouds, all creeping things, humanity, and all there is. This is revelations.unveiled.detroit. Happy Holy Sabbath, family. We are back again under the grace and blessings of the holy power to bestow upon us another 7 days, the gift of breath and life. And we are here together because we are at rest and reverence and honor of the glory and power of the holy power creator of all. And I'm glad to see you. I'm glad to be with you. The revelations.unveiled.detroit den is open. The log is burning. The carpet is freshly vacuumed. The air is wonderfully vibrant and fragrant. The pillows are fluffed. Hopefully our bellies are stuffed. We have exposed our cranial universes as we surrender our carnal commonality, and our souls are exposed for the fire and the heat of the wisdoms of the word of the Lord, the precepts of perfection, so that we can maintain our spiritual infection. And family, to the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel scattered abroad, greetings and love to you wherever you may be upon this planet. And to my pending Israelite brothers and sisters, the Moors and Melanated, original man and children of God, the sovereigns and sojourners, the copper colored, the people of color, the colored, the indigenous and aboriginals, the natives, Negroes and niggas, the Afro-African Americans and blacks, the descendants of slaves and those conquered and colonized, file in. Let us begin to relax and absorb the wonderfulness of the word of all imagination. And this week, family, we will be continuing our review with Brother Prophet King Solomon, the son of King David, as he is in the constructions of the holy place of the word of the power of the creator of all praises. And we are sadly transitioning into a new series of wisdom. We will not fret at the loss of the Song of Solomon. It shall be with us in perpetuity and on the playlist. But we will become introduced today to a brother who goes by the same, or who had the same name as what the world calls the Holy Messiah. And we will be exploring the dualities of wisdoms of the Old Testament, as well as those of the apocryphal text. All praises. I am excited. So, without much more ado, we will prepare ourselves for the spiritual battle with the revelations.unveiled.detroit standards. And we begin in the book of Malachi, chapter 3, verse 6. For I am the Lord, I change not. Therefore, you sons of Jacob are not consumed. Followed by our second standard of eternity. In the book of Hebrews, chapter 8, No, chapter 13, verse 8, in reference to the Holy Messiah, the Redeemer, the Wonderful, the Savior, the King of Israel, whom the world refers to as Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever. All praises, family. So we have our sword and our shield and our cranial universes and our opening exposed spirits. We are ready to enjoy the series of Song of Salvation as we sit in silence. And we began in the book of 1 Kings, chapter 6, verses 31 through 38. And for the entering of the oracle, he made doors of olive tree. The lintel and side posts were a fifth part of the wall. The two doors also were of olive tree, and he carved upon them carvings of cherubims and palm trees and open flowers, and overlaid them with gold, and spread gold upon the cherubims and upon the palm trees. So also made he for the door of the temple post of olive tree, a fourth part of the wall. And the two doors were of fir tree, the two leaves of one door were folding, and the two leaves of the other door were folding. And he carved thereon cherubims and palm trees and open flowers, and covered them with gold fitted upon the carved work. And he built the inner court with three rows of hewed stone and a row of cedar beams. In the fourth year was the foundation of the house of the Lord laid, in the month of Ziph. And in the 11th year, in the month of Bul, which is the 8th month, was the house finished throughout all the parts thereof, and according to all the fashion of it, so was he 7 years in building it. And we continue in the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 4, verses 19 through 22. And Solomon made all the vessels that were for the house of God, the altar also, and the tables whereon the showbread was set, gold. Moreover, the candlesticks with their lamps, that they should burn after the manner before the oracle, of pure gold. And the flowers and the lamps and the tongs made he of gold, and that perfect gold. And the snuffers and the basins and the spoons and the censers of pure gold. And the entry of the house, the inner doors thereof, for the most holy place, and the doors of the house of the temple were of gold. Oh, yes, family. So we see Brother Prophet King Solomon spared no expense, as should you not, in the construction of the house of the holy power. All praises. Gold, the finest hewn wood and stone and precious diamonds. Oh yes, a sample of beauty of the heavenly realm on earth. All right. And so we glide and slide, and we reach for our supersonic 3,000 dimensional view glasses of the universe as we get to the book of Ecclesiastes in its excellence. And so we grab the hands of our neighbors. We sit firm in our places. We bow our head and let our spiritual eyes open and begin to see. The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 9, verse 1. For all this I considered in my heart, even to declare all this, that the righteous and the wise and their works are in the hand of God. No man knows either love or hatred by all that is before them. All things come alike to all. There is one event to the righteous and to the wicked, to the good and to the clean and to the unclean, to him that sacrifices and to him that sacrifices not. As is the good, so is the sinner, and he that swears as he that fears an oath. This is an evil among all things that are done under the sun, that there is one event unto all. Yeah, also the heart of the sons of men is full of evil, and madness is in their heart while they live, and after that they go to the dead. For to him that is joined to all living there is hope, for a living dog is better than a dead lion. For the living know that they shall die, but the dead not know not anything, neither have they any more a reward, for the memory of them is forgotten. Verse 5, for the living know they shall die, but the dead know not anything, neither have they any more a reward, for the memory of them is forgotten. Also their love and their hatred and their envy is now perished. Neither have they any more a portion forever in anything that is done under the sun. Verse 7, go your way, eat your bread with joy, and drink your wine with a merry heart, for God now accepts your works. Let your garments always be white, and let your head lack no ointment. Live joyfully with the wife whom you lovest all the days of your life. Verse 9. Live joyfully with the wife upon whom you lovest all the days of the life of your vanity, which he has given you under the sun, all the days of your vanity, for that is your portion in this life and in your labor which you takest under the sun. Whatsoever your hand finds to do, do it with your might, for there is no work, no device, no knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave, which you go. I returned and saw under the sun that the race is not to the swift, nor the battle to the strong, neither yet bread to the wise, nor yet riches to the man of understanding, nor yet favor to men of skill, but time and chance happens to them all. For man also knows not his time, as the fishes that are in an evil net, and as the birds that are caught in the snare, so are the sons of men snared in an evil time, when it falls suddenly upon them. This wisdom have I seen also under the sun, and it seemed great unto me. Verse 14, there was a little city and few men within it. And there came a great king against it and besieged it and built great bulwarks against it. Now there was found in it a poor wise man, and he by his wisdom delivered the city. Yet no man remembered that same poor man. Then said I, wisdom is better than strength. Nevertheless, the poor man's wisdom is despised, and his words are not heard. The words of the wise man are heard in quiet more than the cry of him that rules among fools. Verse 18. Wisdom is better than weapons of war, but one sinner destroys much good. Verse 18. Wisdom is better than weapons of war, but one sinner destroys much good. Whew. All right, family. Oh, I did it again, my usual after Ecclesiastes. So be it. This is the absorption of wisdom. At the time you receive it, it may be overwhelming, but we will let it settle upon our cranial universes and souls like a wonderful, warm dew. And we proceed with our wisdom exception. Acceptance, application, observation. In the book of Proverbs, chapter 9, verse 1. Wisdom has builded her house. She hath hewn out her seven pillars. She has killed her beasts. She has mingled her wine. She has also furnished her table. She has set forth her maidens. She crieth upon the highest places of the city. Whoso is simple, let him turn and hear. As for him that wants understanding, she said to him, come eat of my bread and drink of my wine, which I have mingled. Forsake the foolish and live. And go in the way of understanding. He that reproves a scorner gets to himself shame, and he that rebukes a wicked man gets himself a blot. Verse 8, reprove not a scorner, lest he hate you. Rebuke not a what? Verse 8, reprove not a scorner, unless he hates you. Rebuke a wise man, and he will love you. Give instruction to a wise man, and he will be yet wiser. Teach a just man, and he will increase in learning. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the holy is understanding. For by me thy days shall be multiplied, and the years of your life shall be increased. If you be wise, you shall be wise for yourself. But if you scorn, you alone shall bear it. A foolish woman is clamorous. She is simple and knows nothing. For she sits at the door of her house on a seat in high places of the city to call passengers who go right on their ways. Whoso is simple, let him turn and hear. As for him that wants understanding, she said to him, stolen waters are sweet, and bread eaten in secret is pleasant. Verse 18, but he knows not that the dead are there, and that her guests are in the depths of hell. That kind of frightened me there, family. Okay. And so, wisdom is flying all through here. Spears and darts is shooting everywhere. All right, I'm catching my breath. Let me, clear my throat. Okay. Oof. So we have our spiritual eye open by Ecclesiastes, and Proverbs has set the table and the bread and the waters and the wine of wisdom. And so we continue down our path this evening, and we are now in the book of wisdom of Solomon, of the apocryphal text. Chapter 9, verse 1. O God of my fathers and Lord of mercy, who has made all things with your word and ordained man through your wisdom, that he should have dominion over the creatures which you have made, and order the world according to the equity and righteousness, and execute judgment with an upright heart. Give me wisdom that sits by your throne, and reject me not from among your children. For I, your servant and son of your handmaid, am a feeble person and of a short time, and too young for the understanding of judgment and laws. For though a man may never so perfect among the children of men, yet if your wisdom be not with him, he shall be nothing regarded. You have chosen me to be king of your people and a judge of your sons and daughters. You have commanded me to build a temple upon the holy mount, and an altar in the city wherein you dwellest, a resemblance of the holy tabernacle which you has prepared from the beginning. And wisdom was with you, which knows your works, and was present when you made the world, and knew what was acceptable in your sight and right in your commandments. O send her out of your holy heavens and from the throne of your glory, that being present, she may labor with me, that I may know what pleases you. For she knows and understands all things, and she shall lead me soberly in my doings and preserve me in her power. So shall my works be acceptable, and then shall I judge your people righteously and be worthy to sit in my father's seat. For what a man is he that can know the counsel of God, or who can think what the will of the Lord is? For the thoughts of a mortal man are miserable, and our devices are but uncertain. For the corruptible body presses down the soul, and the earthy tabernacle weighs down the mind that muses upon many things. And hardly do we guess aright at things that are upon the earth, and with labor do we find the things that are before us. But the things that are in the heaven, who has searched out? And your counsel, who has known, except you given wisdom and send your Holy Spirit from above? Verse 18. For so the ways of them which lived on the earth were reformed, and men were taught the things that are pleasing unto you, and were saved through wisdom. All praises, family. That was Brother Prophet King Solomon petitioning most humbly that the Holy Power Creator release the Holy Spirit, which is wisdom, which is by his throne to come upon earth amongst men and teach us the paths of immortality and eternity. So simple. And now, introducing the book of Ecclesiasticus, of the apocryphal text, and we shall begin in chapter 1, verse 1. The prologue of the wisdom of Jesus, the son of Sirach, whereas many and great things have been delivered unto us by the law and the prophets, and by others that have followed their steps. For the things which Israel ought to be commended for learning and wisdom, and whereof not only the readers must needs become skillful themselves, but also they that desire to learn, to be able to profit them which are without, both by speaking and writing. My grandfather Jesus, when he had much given himself to the reading of the law and the prophets and other books of our fathers, and had gotten there in good judgment, was drawn on also himself to write something pertaining to learning and wisdom, to the intent that those things which are desirous to learn and are addicted to these things which profit much more in living according to the law. Wherefore, let me entreat you to read it with favor and attention, and to pardon us, wherein we may seem to come short of some words which we have labored to interpret. For the same things uttered in Hebrew and translated into another tongue have not the same force in them. And not only these things, but the law itself and the prophets and the rest of the books have no small difference when they are spoken in their own language. For in the 8th and 30th year coming into Egypt, when Ergetes was king and continuing there for some time, I found a book with no small learning. Therefore, I thought it most necessary for me to bestow some diligence and travail to interpret it, using great watchfulness and skill in that place to bring the book to an end and set it forth for them also, which in a strange country are willing to learn, being prepared before in manners to live after the law. All wisdom comes from the Lord and is with him forever. Who can number the sand of the sea and the drops of rain and the days of eternity? Who can find out the height of heaven and the breadth of the earth and the deep and wisdom? Wisdom has been created before all things, and the understanding of prudence from everlasting. The word of God Most High is the fountain of wisdom, and her ways are everlasting commandments. To whom has the root of wisdom been revealed? Or who has known her wise counsels? Unto whom has the knowledge of wisdom been made manifest? And who has understood her great experience? There is one wise and greatly to be feared, the Lord sitting upon his throne. He created her and saw her and numbered her and poured her out upon all his works. Verse 10, she is with all flesh according to his gift, and he has given her to them that love him. The fear of the Lord is honor and glory and gladness and a crown of rejoicing. The fear of the Lord maketh a merry heart and gives joy and gladness and a long life. Whoso fears the Lord, it shall go well with him at the last, and he shall find favor in the day of his death. To fear the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and it was created with the faithful in the womb. She has built an everlasting foundation with men, and she shall continue with their seed. To fear the Lord is fullness of wisdom, and fills a man with her fruits. She fills all their houses with things desirable, and the garners with her increase. The fear of the Lord is a crown of wisdom, making peace and perfect health to flourish. Both. Which are gifts of God. Verse 18. The fear of the Lord is a crown of wisdom, making peace and perfect health to flourish. But which are gifts of God, and it enlarges their rejoicing that love him. Wisdom rains down skill and knowledge of understanding, standing, and exalting them to honor that hold her fast. The root of wisdom is to fear the Lord, and the branches thereof are long life. The fear of the Lord drives away sins, and where it is present, it turns away wrath. A furious man cannot be justified, for the sway of his fury shall be his destruction. A patient man may tear for a time, and afterward joy shall spring up unto him. He will hide his words for a time, and the lips of many shall declare his wisdom. The parables of knowledge are in the treasures of wisdom, but godliness is an abomination to a sinner. If you desire wisdom, keep the commandments of the Lord, and the Lord shall give her unto you. For fear of the Lord is wisdom and instruction, and faith and meekness are his delight. Distrust not the fear of the Lord when you are poor, and come not unto him with a double heart. Be not a hypocrite in the sight of men, and take good heed what you speak. Verse 30, exalt not thyself, lest you fall and bring dishonor upon your soul, and so God discover your secrets and cast you down in the midst of the congregation, because you came not in truth to the fear of the Lord, but your heart was full of deceit. Oh, praise his family. Woo, family. You have endured, a good 70 verses of pure, righteous wisdom and instruction and immortality. after application. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. Blessed are all they that keep his commandments. We are learning in this ninth week of the Sabbath Wisdom Series, the intermingling of the law and the wisdom, which is our heritage. This is why it bears upon our spirits. This is why a lot of our people reject this word, because they know it's the truth. All praises. And yes, family, this is the ninth week of the Sabbath Wisdom Series. We have laid before with patience and humility ourselves to construct a path in this carnal container by which our conscious acknowledgement realizes we are spiritual seekers and searchers for salvation. And Lord will, if it be thus and so, by his grace and power and mercy, that we are able to maintain the gift of breath and life, we shall continue in our washing of the word with wisdom. And my family, to the 12 tribes scattered abroad, wherever you may be, my continuous petition in prayer for your care and safety, your peace and harmony, as we persevere and endure, as we try to overcome, to be right, righteous, and ready upon the return of the Holy King Messiah. And as we depart, as is the standard of revelations.unveil.detroit, we continue to define and refine our walks on the path of righteousness given to us as an example by the anointed Messiah, the Redeemer, the Wonderful, the Savior, the King of Israel, whom the world refers to as Jesus Christ, who is the Word of the holy power of creation made flesh. The same word written on stone by the holy power creator's own finger and given to brother prophet Moses to present to the congregation and the church of the nation of Israel as a holy covenant to observe and to do, so that we may be deemed worthy to enter into the 12 gates of the kingdom of heaven on earth. Let it be done. So be it. And family, as we take these wisdoms out into the carnal world and we become a light to all that see, how will we were exposed to the righteous reality? Let us be humble. Let us be patient. Let us be charitable. Let us be kind. We never know when we may be entertaining the presence and company of the holy messengers of the power. And family, you already know, but I love saying it anyway. I love you. I love you, family. I love you. And until we are together again, be at peace. Hold fast. Stand strong. This is revelations.unveil.detroit. The book of Deuteronomy, chapter 7, verses 6 through 9. For we are a holy people unto the Lord our God. The Lord our God has chosen us to be a special people unto himself, above all people that are upon the face of the earth. The Lord did not set his love upon us, nor choose us because we were more in number than any people. For we were the fewest of all people. But because the Lord loved us, and because he would keep the oath which he had sworn to our fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, has the Lord brought us out with a mighty hand and redeemed us out of the house of bondmen from the hand of Pharaoh, king of Egypt. Verse 9. Know therefore that the Lord our God, he is God, the faithful God, which keeps covenant and mercy with them that love him and keep his commandments to a thousand generations. And to the scattered tribes, here is your promise of comfort. Book of John, chapter 3, verses 14 through 17, into Isaiah, chapter 45, verse 17. And as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Verse 17, for God sent not his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Isaiah 45, 17. But Israel shall be saved in the Lord with an everlasting salvation. You shall not be ashamed nor confounded. World without end.